Sauce Now is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started.
Number 30, back to return.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's to the 40. Makes it out to about the 46.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 46. He has some room. Tackled after a decent pickup. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Goes middle of the tight end. That's a great tackle
at the 45-yard line.
So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
From the 45-yard line, third down. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. And that'll give him another first down.
Excellent job there, Brad, of running the football. That was good execution by this offense.
Tackle made at about the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, second down. He makes his way to about the 28.
Gain of 9 yards. Third down.
Down he goes at the 20-yard line.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise, being able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
And a halfback carry for a pickup of 3.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Second and 6. Ball on the 17. He holds on to it and gets maybe 2 yards.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
10th play of the drive.
Strip that ball. Mike 4.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Touchdown. You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens? And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 71-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
The score now, 7-0. He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. The Hurricanes and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
Second down and six. Ball on the 36-yard line. Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
First down. From their own 47-yard line. First down. Tackle at the 43.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Third down again. Here they come. He wants it all, going long. And he hits him hard at the 21.
That makes it first and 10.
Runs it left for a decent gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. They'll bring him down around the 19-yard line.
He wasn't decisive at all on that option. Once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
Yet to go, but at the end of one, the Bearcats with a touchdown lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Play action. Brought down at the 18. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's taken down at about the 21.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. They get a good 7 yards on that one.
Well, the defense decided to sit back in zone. And anytime you're a quarterback and you see zone, you want to get rid of the ball quickly if a man is open on that slant route because it could go for a big play. but the defense does a good job of keeping it in check and making the tackle.
Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down at the 36. From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop right around the 32-yard line.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Zips it to the back.
Fumble.
It's picked up. He's at the 40. He's tackled around the 33-yard line.
Great example of an opportunistic defense coming up with the fumble.
They put some points on the board in their last drive, and they'll start this one in position to do much of the same.
The defense has their backs against the wall here. They're really going to have to get aggressive if they want to keep the offense from scoring any points here.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. From the 15, the Hurricanes struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how he can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play. One touch could get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
He's at midfield. Gets out to around the 45.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
That brings up second and 13.
Rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35. And he is drilled at the 45.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those as an offensive lineman. When the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
He really got a hold of that one. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
The cavalry's coming. Grabs it and hammered right there. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Tackles him hard at the 27-yard line. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Oh, excellent punt. Gets to about the 41-yard line. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook. And he's level at the 33-yard line. They come out in a five-wide set. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. Couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. And down he goes at the 27. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Throws it in a hurry. That's a great tackle at the 41-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From their own 41-yard line. First down. Throws to the tailback, incomplete. Throw to the tight end, and down he goes around the 46-yard line. They gained 5 yards there.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of five.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They push him out at the 30-yard line.
Looks like the defense played the run that time. With this offense, you've got to be ready for a pass on any down in any situation.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. The kick is up, and he got it. might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime. Gets out to about the 31. So both teams will go to the locker room looking to make some adjustments and find some second half offense. The Bearcats lead 10-3.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half. And you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of. And it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes. Because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and Davis, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 33. The Bearcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. It out to maybe the 33-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 33. And he's tackled around the 37-yard line.
Number 97 brings him down on the 37-yard line. That'll make it 35.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Caught out in the open. Tackle at the 49.
The reception. Number 8 makes the tackle at the 49-yard line.
From their own 49-yard line. First down. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. And a quick throw. And he's shoved out of bounds to the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll
make it 7-4. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. Kicks away.
And he nails the long field goal.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Picked up a yard, if anything, on that run.
And that was the freshman linebacker who was right there to make the play.
Makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 32. Catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down at the 45-yard line. Makes it to the 41. From the 41-yard line, it's first down. Brought down around the 29-yard line. Sheds that one, and they got him for a loss.
Loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
Second and 14. Ball on the 33-yard line. Scrambling around. And he hits him hard at the 29-yard line.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Throws a strike over the middle. He's taken down at the 20. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. A short yardage defense here. Makes it out to about the 10. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Tackled for a loss. It's second and goal. Ball on the 11-yard line. And they make the stop at the 9-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it third and goal.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Five wide. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
And he converts the extra point. So an 11-play, 68-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 17-6. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. and it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield. Still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 17-6, Bearcats. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Going deep. Complete. He's got room. Touchdown. Big play.
Yeah, baby. It's my boy.
So obviously a lot of excitement about that score here early in the fourth quarter, but they've got to get their heads back in it now. We've got a tight football game and a long way to go. So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Caught it, and the conversion is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game, and every possession is going to count from here on out. Gets to around the 42. From their own 42-yard line. First down. Good tackle there in space. Taken down right around the 34. First and 10, ball on the 34-yard line. Runs it right, nice pickup. From the 23-yard line. First down. Tackle made around the 20-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Get up.
up the middle, and he's stuffed.
That is a loss of 3 yards. Third down.
Third and 8. All on the 21. Less than 3 minutes in the game. The catch and look out. Touchdown. That was a well drawn up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
That's a great touchdown, Brad, but what happened to the coverage there by the defense? The defensive coordinator's got to be beside himself. You know, you work all week long on studying the offense and their tendencies, and then to have a mental error and to leave the star receiver open like that for a touchdown, well, they've got to regroup.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
Not sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Picked off by the safety. Boy, the defense was all over the ball in the air, and they come away with a dagger of an interception. From the 43-yard line, it's first down. Just under 2 to go in the game. Makes it out to about the 33.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. The Hurricanes call a timeout. That's their second of the half. And down he goes at the 18-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 18. Gets out to around the 9. Score here late in the fourth quarter, and now they've given themselves some breathing room in this football game. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 5-play, 45-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. They can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So our score, 31-14. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Bearcats have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
Nothing left here except to see the clock hit 0. A comeback is just not happening. There's a strike complete. He's tackled around the 33-yard line.
Makes it second and 2.
Under a minute left in the game. The spike will stop the clock. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Here comes the pressure. He lets it fly. Tackle around the 35-yard line.
It's really difficult to cover somebody this fast. You can't stay with him in one-on-one coverage. And even when you double-team him, he still has the speed to beat you. You just have to hope that the timing is off between him and his quarterback.
Quick pass. He steps out at the 33. And so it's another third down upcoming here. He goes out of bounds around the 26-yard line. Defense stacked in tight here. And they push him out at the 9.
That's a gain of 17. That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. And he's tackled around the 1 yard line. Spikes the ball.
That makes it third and
10th play of the drive. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. Canes, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.